In this video, we are going to see about the multiplication algorithm of binary multiplication. How to do the binary multiplication. So first, let us see an example of binary multiplication. So here is 10111 is one number, and that we call it as multiplicand, which is multiplied by this number, which is nothing but we call it as multiplier. So what is the general rule? If there is a 1, when you are multiplying, whenever there is a 1, you just copy the number that is multiplicable. See, for example, here, we will start from least significant bit. So let us consider the first least significant bit. This is nothing but our 1. So 1 into 10111, you have this. Then take the next question. This you have to write it just like our ordinary decimal multiplication. You take the next position, that is towards left, and then you start writing. Now the next is 1. So when you multiply this with 1, you will get the same answer, multiplicate. So that you write. So here the position is not here, it is from here. Then 0 means you just write it. Again 0, you copy by shifting 1 position left. And then finally here 1, again you write. Now add all these things, you get the product. This is how we do the multiplication. So if the multiplied bit is 1, the multiplicand is copied. That's what we have done. Multiplicand is copied. Else, zeros are copied. The numbers copied down in successive lines are shifted one position to the left. If the first one we are writing, while writing the second one, we shift one position towards the left from the previous number. Finally, numbers are added, and their sum form the product. The sign of the product is determined from the sign of the multiplicand multiplier. If they are alike, sign of the product is positive. See here, what is it? We have to check the sign of the product. If both the signs are same, so for example, if we know the rule, minus into minus, you have plus. Okay, so both the signs are same, you have positive. If both are plus, again, in that case also you have positive. When one is plus and another one is minus, then you have negative. The result is a negative number. So this rule we know, all of us know. Then another example for unsigned binary multiplication. If it is a sign, then we have to follow this rule. For unsigned, you want me to explicitly note down the number of sign bit. So here, this is multiplicand is 11, equivalent is 11, and this is 13. And the final product will be 143. It is 11 into 13, you have 143. Here also we did the same. When there is a 1, then you just copy. When there is a 0, you shift it and write zeros. 1, again you shift the left position and write the multiplicand. In all cases, you will write the multiplicand, and then finally you write the product. That is, you add, see here, 1, here 1, and then 1 plus 1 plus 1, triple 1. That is 1. So 1, and there will be carry. So 1 plus 1 is 0, again 1 carry. 1 plus 1, 1, 0. So 0, 1 carry here, 1 plus 1, 0, and 1 carry. Now we'll see the hardware implementation of the multiplication algorithm. Here, what we have to do is first we'll see the algorithm. Initially, the multiplicand is stored in M register. Here, let us say this is the M register, and another register is that we call it as Q register. So, multiplicand is stored. The first value is stored here, and the multiplier is stored in Q. Okay, and with the help of adder and shift and add control logic, we do this shifting one here. We add and then shift. That's for that purpose we have this. So this is these are all the necessary things for a hardware implementation. That is, we need two registers and then one accumulator. This is also another register. So let us see it as a register itself. M register, A register, Q register, and one flip-flop. Here is a flip-flop carry to hold the carry bit, and we need addition logic and shift logic. Okay, so using this, we can implement the multiplication. Now we'll see how we can do. Whenever there is a one which is occurring in the multiplier, then what we have to do, what we have done, whenever there is a one, we just copied the multiplicand. Whenever there is a zero, we did the zero. We copy the zero, right? Here, we are going to add, we are not going to add like this. It is all the values. This is our normal, when you take a paper, you write like this. Okay, when you work out in a paper, you work out like this. But in system, you don't do that. First, you write this, and then write this. You add these two, store the intermediate result in your A register, and then again, by checking this value, you write this multiplicand and add this with the accumulator intermediate result. You will get, when you add these two, you will get some answer, isn't it? So for example, see here, 10111, you will get answer 111, then 0, sorry, 10. One, one, zero. This is the intermediate result of these two values. Then what you will be doing? You are adding 1011. Which question here? Today, one, two, third question. So add this, and this is what you get. And then you add 1101. One you get, and then you add this one. So this is the intermediate result. So when you add, you will be getting 0, 1, 1. Okay. Now you have to add this. So for that, you will be leaving 1, 2, 3 bits. Shift 2 bits. 1, 1, 0. Then, now when you add 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, and this is your problem. Okay, so this is how you work out. That is, these two first you add, and then with that result, this is the result of these two addition. This bit is again added. This value is, that is multiplicand is added. And then with that intermediate result, again, the last one is added. This is for left shifting. But there is an algorithm where we carry over the right shift, which will be more better. So more easier. So that is what we are going to see. Here, the multiplicand is kept in a register called M, and multiplier is kept in register called Q. And then we have the A register and carry bit. Carry bit flip-flops. Now what we do is, whenever there is a, we have to shift right. So here, whenever based on the last bit, that is what here also we did. First this bit we take, then the next bit we take, then and so on. So here, this Q bit is shifted. So the last bit, based on the last bit, if it is a one, then multiplicand is added to the intermediate result of accumulator. And then the value is shifted towards right. Once added, it will be shifted towards right, along with carry, accumulator, and two. So in which case, carry bit is shifted to AN-1, that is the most significant bit of A. And then A0 is shifted to QN-1. That is the least significant bit of A is shifted to most significant bit of the multiplier, this Q. And this bit is lost. Okay. So here, let us see the algorithm. Initially, multiplicand is stored in M register. That's what. Multiplicand is stored in M register, and multiplier is stored in Q register. The sign of register M and Q, that is the sign bit. the most significant bit are compared using XOR. If both are same, then the output of XOR operation is zero, that is positive, unless it is negative. And the output is stored in sign bit of A, because in A only we keep the intermediate result. And final result also will be, we can find combined together A and Q. The initially, zero is assigned to the register A. Okay, so this is the algorithm. M is stored in multiplicand, Q multiplier, and C is a carry bit. A is, initially C is also zero, A is zero, and count, we have to keep the count, because if you take this number, 1, 2, 3, 4, four times you have to do the shifting. So in order to know that, we have to calculate the number of bits in the multiplier. Okay, so that we will found and store it in the count. So when we have to start decreasing, when it becomes zero, it means the multiplication is over and we can find the output. Since we are doing the addition then and there, in A, you can find the output in combined of A and Q. So the number of bits in Q, that is in the multiplier. So count will consist of number of bits of Q. Now, we check, is Q naught is one means the last bit. It is nothing but this. And then this, and so on. If Q naught is zero, that is one, then you do the addition. Okay. The value of A is added with M value in the M, which is nothing but our multiplier. If zero, okay, if no means zero, then right shift. Here you add the data and then this step has to be done. Only this step is skipped if it is zero. So multiplicand is not added. But when it is equal to one, multiplicand is added and then a right shift, that is along with the carry A and Q, one shift takes place towards right. Then you decrement the count. So here also when there is zero, because we have found there is one by one, since one bit is reduced because of zero and one, we reduce the count by minus one. Then finally, it has to end. So how the multiplication ends? By checking the count. If it is equal to zero, then stop. Else, you do the operations again. So this is the algorithm. That's what written here also. Now the least significant bit of multiplier is checked. That's what I have said now. If it is one, add the content of register A with the multiplicand. And the result is assigned in A register with carry bit in flip-flop C. The content of CAQ, it is CAQ, is shifted to right by one position. That is, content of C is shifted to most significant bit of A. That is, this is shifted to MSB. This is the most significant bit. And then A is shifted to the least significant bit of A is shifted to most significant bit of Q. This is shifted to this, MSB of Q. Then the least significant bit of Q naught here, this is lost. This is not shifted back. This is lost. So this will be Q1 is overwriting Q naught and so on. So if Qn equal to zero, if the last bit, if this consists of zero, only shift the, make a right shift. Okay, along with CAQ. Or else, if it is one, add and then shift. The content of sequence counter is decremented by one. That is, this count is decremented by one. Check the content. If it is zero, check the content of count. If it is zero, end the process and final product is present in the register A and Q. Else, repeat the process. Now we'll see with an example. Now we are going to multiply 15 by 11. The 15 equivalent is this and 11 equivalent is this. So A is the register where initially 000 is there. C is the carry bit flip-flop. So that is also one register flip-flop. Then M is the M register where you store the multiplicand. Then initially count is one because the number of bits in multiplier is 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. That we write. So now we check what is the value of Q according to our algorithm. All these are initialized. So in Q register, we have placed multiplier. In M register, we have placed the multiplicand. Then in count register, we are keeping one more register for count, that is 4. Or we can keep it as a variable, okay, as 4. And then A as the register where it is initialized to 0. And then C, carry bit is 0. Now, all this initialization is there. Now, according to our algorithm, we check this last bit. Okay, because we have to check only Q. Check the last bit. It is 1. So, what we do? We add this multiplicand with the content of A. Now, after adding these two, so now we do the add A equal to A plus M. After this, our A register will consist of this. And this does not produce any carry. So, carry is 0. Then after adding, you have to make a right shift. So, along with all these three registers has to be shifted one right. So, in this case, when I shift here, what happened? Here. This bit is last. Okay. So, now this is shifted. This is shifted one. And then see here, this is shifted like this. And this carry bit shifted as the last bit. This is what I said. Carry bit is shifted to the most significant bit of A. And the least significant bit of A is shifted to the most significant bit of Q. And the last value, the less significant bit of Q is last. Okay. It is overwritten by this. Now, next is, now this is the current value of Q. After shifting, you have to take this as the current value. Since we have shifted, and since one shift is done, you reduce the count to 3. Okay. Now, what happens? Again, you check the last bit. This is where we stop. So when you check, this is 1 again. Now what we have to do? We have to add the content of accumulated with M and then do a right shift. So now what we do is we have to add 1, 1, 1 with this value. Okay. This value. The current accumulated value, the A value is this. So 0, 1, 1. Okay, and what is this? Multiplicand has to be added. Now we'll see what happens. 1, 1, 1 to 0. 1, here 1 is done. So it's 1. Here again carry. So it is 1. Again a carry. It is 1. And we have a carry. So that is what here. Carry. The output is stored here. 0, 0, 1, 1, 0. This is an operator and this is a carry bit. Now you write the value of Q here. This is the latest value of Q. So that we have written here. And then we have to do a logical, after addition, we do a logical right shift. So now what happens? See here, this value is last. Now this is shifter 1, 1, and this 0. Now this, because this is the current value of A, isn't it? So now, after shifting here, here and this one comes here. Now this is the latest value of A and this is the latest value of Q. Since we have done one logical right shift, we decrement the count to 2. Then now you check this value. Now this is Q value and this is the A value. Now the Q value, you always check the least significant bit. Now this is 0. So you are not supposed to add, but just do logical right shift. And because whenever you do a logical right shift, you have to do a decrement of the count. So now it becomes 1. And what we have done? We have done this right shift. So this is gone. And this is there. See here? Now, so shifter, shifter, shifter. And this 0 is shifted. Okay. Now, what happened? Now, this is the latest value of accumulator, A, and this is the latest value of Q, right? Now, again, we check, since it is 1, we have some more to do. So, when it becomes 0 only, we stop the operation. Now, you check this, Q is 1. So, again, what we have to do, we have to add this with the multiplicand. So what is the latest value of A? 0, 1, 0, 1. And then now what is our multiplier? I'm sorry, multiplicand. All four. So 1, 1, 0, carry, 2, 0, and 1. Now we have the carry and sorry, I think I have done boundary. It's 1, 1, so 0, and here 1 we have, so it is 1, here we have, it is 0 and 1. So 1 is a carry and 0, 1, 0, 0 is the product, so S, addition. And then here again, what is the position after this? It is the same. Okay. Now what we do, we have done the addition and the Q value is this. Now we have to, after addition, we have to do a right shift. So now this value is gone. Okay. So this 1, 0, 1, and then this. This 0, 1, 0, and this 1 is from this country. Okay. Now, finally, this becomes 0 and we have to stop according to our algorithm. See here, if count equal to 0, stop. So now we stop this. This is our answer. Whatever the value, now, whatever the value present in A and Q, you have to take the value along with A and Q. Now this is your CAQ. Now this is your output. Whatever is present, the 3 registers, that is your answer. So if you find that, see here, you take this 2 power 0. It is 2 power 1 is that, 2 power 2, 3 is 0, 4 is 0. So 5, 2 power 5, 6 is 0, and 2 power 7 is that. When you add all these things, you get the 165, which is nothing but equal to 15 into 11. Now, now we'll see for, we'll take another example and work out. This is 10111 and 10011. This is a multiplicand. It is M, we keep the multiplicand and Q multiplier. The value equivalent is 23 into 19, which is nothing but 437 answer. Now we'll check whether we are getting this. Okay. Now, in A, initially, according to our algorithm, C flip flop is 0, A is 0, because this is what going to keep the intermediate result. And Q is the multiplier and M is the multiplicand. Initially 5, because 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 values are there in our multiplier. 5 bits are there. That is what our initialization is done. Then 0, we add this and this, we get this. Okay. So, and Q is as such, we have added. Now what we have to do, we have to do a right shift. So right shift and less the count. So now it becomes 4. Now here, this is loss. Now see here, this is shifted. This one becomes here. 1, 1, 1, 1. And this carry bit is shifted. Okay. Now the next one, again, we check. Now since it is shifted, now this has been shifted, our data becomes, Q becomes this. Now, again, we check the last bit, it is 1. So what will be the next step? We have to add. So when you add, add A with multiplier. So let us see 0. See here I have worked out. See 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. And then this value, that is multiplier, 1, 0, 1. So when you add this 1, 1 to 0, 1 is a carry. So 1, 1, 1, triple 1, so 1. And here again, 1 carry, 1 plus 1 it is 0, 1 carry, 1 plus 1 it is 0, again 1 carry, 1 plus 1 it is 0, and then we have a carry. So here, this answer is 1, we have a term, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0. This is our answer. So 1 is carry, carry is separately written here. And then, what is our Q? The current state of Q is this, that has been written as such. The next step is logical shift, right? And then subtract count. So by 1. 3. It becomes 3. And now we have shifted. This value is lost. So yeah, shift right. This 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, and then this 1 comes here. Okay, so now this is the output. Now A is having this value A and Q is having this value. Okay, now the value is also reduced to 3. So two more data has to be reduced. There are two more informations in multiplayer. Two more count has to be done. Then, now what is that? We check the last one. It is 0. So when there is a 0, just shift right and reduce the count. The count is reduced. What we have done? See here, we have shifted. This is our queue. And we have shifted like this. This is last. Okay, by checking this is 0. So and then we are doing a logical shifted. This is last. So now here, one right shift is done. And then this. Okay, and this is done. So here. And this 0 is transferred here. And this is, after transfer, this becomes 0. Now, this is where, this is what data in A register and Q register after the left shift. Now, again, we check the last bit. After shifting, 0 is at the last. Now, you check this 0. So, now you do again a logical shift. So, in this case, we do like this. See here? Shipping. Okay, now in this case, after shifting, you reduce it to 1. The count is reduced. Now 1. Now what happens? The last bit you also. Here when you check 0, after shifting it becomes 1. Now you check this 1. So now what you have to do? You have to add the multiplicand with the accumulator value, which is nothing but what is that accumulator value here. This is the accumulator value 0010. And you have to add it with the multiplicand. So 10111 is the multiplicand. So add 1, 1, and here you have this one. One, one, zero, and here it is carry. So 1, and we have 1. Now you write this. This is the, there is no carry. Okay, so 0 carry 1, 1, 1, 0. You write the value in A, and then this is the value in Q. Now, after adding, you reduce the count. Now it becomes 0. Then you do a logical shift right. So here, what you do? This value is lost. So 0, 0, 0. Here 1 is shifted. 1, 1, and 1. Okay. And this is a Q. Now, this is our answer. Now you write the intermediate value. There is a write the equivalent binary equivalent decimal. So what happens? 2 is the, so it's 2 power 0. 2 power 0, 1 is not that, 2 is that, 2 power 2, 3 is not that, 2 power 4 that, 2 power 5, 2 power 6 is not that, 7 and 8. So when you find out the decimal equivalent, you get the 437. What is the answer? This is your answer. When you take 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. So this is your answer. So this is how you have to find out the algorithm. Work out the algorithm that you can check your answer. So whenever there is a, in register M, you have multiplicand, in register Q, you have multiplier and count. So the number of bits gives the comb. Okay, so when you do any addition and then logical shift right, you have to press the comb. So when keep on press the keep on reduce the comb and then it becomes zero, you will have the answer in your AC, AQ combined together, you have the answer. So now you check whether the last bit of Q is 1. If it is 1, then you add and then do a right shift. If it is 0, then you just do the right shift. And in both cases, after doing this, you reduce the count. When the count reaches 0, you have reached the answer. Or else you have to repeat the process in order to achieve, in order to do the multiplication.